لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين قائد الغر المحجلين وإمام المتقين وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه الطاهرات أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الكريم والسيد السند العظيم وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. نسألك اللهم به صلى الله عليه وسلم أن تفتح لنا أبواب معارفه صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأن تعلمنا من علومه صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأن تفقهنا من فقهه صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأن تنور بواطننا وظواهرنا به صلى الله عليه وسلم، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا ووفقنا للعمل فيما يرضيك عنا، بجاهه صلى الله عليه وسلم عندك وبسر الفاتحة. بسم الله to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Lord of the heavens and the earth. We ask Him to send His peace and blessings and rest upon His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the household of His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the companions of His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the blessed wives of His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all of those who followed after them with excellence up until the day of standing. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to include us from amongst them. Ameen, Ameen, Ameen. Thereafter the great Imam, Muhaddis of the Haramain al-Sharifain, Sayyid Muhammad bin Alawi rahmatullahi alayhi, he says in his book, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-insan al-kamil, O Master Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the perfect man, hikamun wa fawaid min shaqqi sadrihi al-sharifi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wisdoms and benefits and lessons that can be derived from his blessed heart, from his blessed chest being opened up and his blessed heart being taken out and washed. So in the previous lessons, the Shaykh radiallahu anhu mentioned that his blessed heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken out 4 times and washed with the water of Zamzam. And he mentioned that the times and the ages in which this took place. And he mentioned that the heart of the Prophet, the characteristics of the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that it's the most purest, strongest, gentlest, softest, most conscious of hearts. Even when his eyes were closed, his heart was conscious and awake and alert of what was happening around him and what was happening in Allah's creation, in the celestial realm and in the lowly realm. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was well aware with the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed onto him what was happening in the heavens and in the earth. Now the Shaykh moves over to speaking about as to why his blessed heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken out and some of the wisdoms that can be derived from his blessed heart being taken out and some questions that need to be answered and some doubts that might be occurring in people's minds as to why his blessed heart was taken out and washed, and why was it mentioned that a piece of flesh that was hazzul shaytan, the portion of the shaytan was taken out from him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why is it that he was created with this and not without it? So the Shaykh radiallahu anhu said, al-fa'idatul ula, as for the first benefit, قال العلامة ابن المنير, the great scholar ابن المنير, he said, وشق الصدر له صلى الله عليه وسلم وصبره عليه من جنس مبدل الله تعالى به الذبيحة وصبر عليه. ابن المنير, he says, The first benefit that can be derived is the similarity between what occurred for Sayyidina Ismail al-Zabih alayhi salam and what occurred for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina al-Zabih, Sayyidina Ismail, who was sacrificed for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was al-Zabih, the sacrificed one. Right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked for his sacrifice from Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, similar thing happened for him, that his blessed heart was taken out of his chest. بَلْ هَذَا أَشَقُّ وَأَجَلُّ لِأَنَّ تِلْكَ مَعَارِيضُ وَهَذِهِ حَقِيقَةٌ. And then he says, but there can't be a comparison, for what occurred for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was more severe and more intense and more majestic, in that his heart in reality was taken out sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whereas Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam, his sacrifice was replaced. His sacrifice was replaced by the sacrificial animal that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent from the heavens. So what occurred for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a comparison from one angle, but from another angle it is much higher and loftier than that which happened for Ismail alayhi salam. وَأَيْضًا فَقَدْ تَكَرَّرَ وَوَقَعَ لَهُ وَهُوَ صَغِيرٌ دُرٌّ يَتِيمٌ بَعِيدٌ عَنْ أَهْلِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And he said, and this also reoccurred. It occurred many times. And one of the times that it occurred was when he was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was an orphan jewel, a single jewel, away from his family, away from Makkah al-Mukarramah, away from his mother, at the age of 4, a very tender age, a very soft, gentle age. And he was far away from his family in the deserts of Banu Sa'd. And this occurred for him, which indicates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing him from a very young age to carry heavy burdens, to carry heavy burdens. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw that his heart was taken out. And the children around him, they also saw that two men came, lay him down. They came back to Sayyidah Halima Sa'diyah and said, our Qurayshite brother has been killed. Our Qurayshite brother, he's been killed. Right? Because they saw that he was laid down, his heart was opened up. And Sayyidah Halima Sa'diyah was frightened and she came running. And she found him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his color had changed. He had gone pale sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she took him in and she was so worried that she went straight back home. Took him back to Makkah al-Mukarramah. Took him back to Makkah al-Mukarramah. Al-Fa'idah al-Thaniyah. He said the second benefit, lesson or wisdom. He says, سُئِلَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ أَبُو الْحَسَنَ السُّبْكِي رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنِ الْعَلَقَةِ السَّوْدَاءِ الَّتِي أُخْرِجَتْ مِنْ قَلْبِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ حِينَ شُقَّ فُؤَادُهُ وَقَوْلُ الْمَلِكِ مَلَكْ هَذَا حَظُّ الشَّيْطَانِ مِنْكِ. This is the great Imam, Shaykh al-Islam Abu al-Hasan al-Subki, was asked concerning the black morsel, the black piece of flesh that was taken out from his blessed heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the statement of the angel, هَذَا حَظُّ الشَّيْطَانِ مِنْكِ, that this is the portion of the shaitan from you. He was asked about this. Why was there a black piece in his heart? And why did the angel have to say to him, this is the shaitan's portion from you? فَأَجَابَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. So he replied, بِأَنَّ تِلْكَ الْعَلَقَةَ خَلَقَهَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي قُلُوبِ الْبَشَرِ. He said, this piece of flesh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it in the hearts of all of mankind. In the entire genus of human beings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it. So it wasn't something that was only in his blessed heart, not in anyone else's heart. This was in every single human being's heart.
قابلة لما يلقيه الشيطان. And it's this piece of fish that is a recipient or is able to receive instructions and messages and thoughts and whispers from the shaitan. فَأُزِيلَتْ مِنْ قَلْبِهِ. So hence it was taken out of his blessed heart. Which meant what? That there was nothing in his blessed heart that could receive messages from the shaitan. Unlike anyone else. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَلَمْ يَبْقَ فِيهِ مَكَانٌ لِأَنْ يُلْقِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ فِيهِ شَيْئًا. So there was no space left in his heart for the shaitan to send any type of thought, whisper, message. هذا معنى الحديث. He said this is the meaning of the hadith. I.e. the hadith in which concerning the opening of his chest and taking out of his heart. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لِلشَّيْطَانِ فِيهِ حَظْ. And the shaitan never had a portion from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَأَمَّا الَّذِي نَفَاهُ الْمَلَكُ فَهُوَ أَمْرٌ فِي الْجِبِلَّةِ الْبَشَرِيَّةِ. And that which was negated by the angel is something that was placed in the hearts of all of mankind, not only the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فأزيل القابل الذي لم يكن يلزم من حصوله حصول القذف في القلب. So this piece of flesh that receives messages from the shaitan was taken out from his heart. So hence, therefore, there was no space for the shaitan to send messages to his blessed heart, صلى الله عليه وسلم. فقيل له. So it was said to him, i.e. to Imam Rasulullah, Allah create this piece of flesh in his blessed heart, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَكَانَ يُمْكِنُ أَنْ لَا يَخْلُقَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِيهَا. And it was possible that Allah doesn't create it in his blessed heart, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقال, and he replied, إِنَّهُ مِنْ جُمْلَةِ الْأَجْزَاءِ الْإِنسَانِيَّةِ. He said, the reason why Allah created it, because it's a part of the nature of man, it's a part of the organs of mankind, to have this piece of flesh. To have this piece of flesh. فَخَلَقَ تَكْمِلَةً لِلْخَلْقِ الْإِنسَانِ. So Allah created it in him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to have a complete creation of man in him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَا بُدَّ مِنْهُ. And it's inevitable to have this piece of flesh. وَنَزَعَهُ كَرَامَةً رَبَّانِيَّةً طَاءَتْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pulled it out from his heart as a divine and lordly ennoblement. Divine and lordly ennoblement for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that occurred. That occurred. This was the answer of Imam al-Subki. وَقَالَ غَيْرُهُ. And others replied to the same question by saying, لو خلق الله تعالى نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم كذلك لم يكن للآدم آدميين اطلاع على حقيقته صلى الله عليه وسلم. Others said that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him without this piece of flesh, without this piece of flesh which is the recipient of the messages and the whisperings of the shaitan, then mankind would have never known of the internal state of the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فأظهره الله تعالى على يد جبريل عليه السلام ليتحققوا كمال باطنه كما برز لهم مكمل الظاهر صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this piece of flesh in him. And then he instructed Jibreel alayhi salam to go and pull it out of his blessed heart so that mankind not only knows of his outer perfection, they also know of his inner perfection. They know of his inner perfection, i.e. the perfection of his blessed heart sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So for example, if it wasn't created in him, then there was nothing to take out. Then there was nothing to take out. And we would have never known of the state of his blessed heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But because it was created and it was placed in his heart, and then his heart was opened up, his chest was opened up, and this piece of flesh was taken out. Now we know the state of his blessed heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in that, in it being absolutely pure. Then the Shaykh said, Al-fa'idatu al-thalitha, as for the third benefit, qala al-shaykh al-imamu Abu Muhammad ibn Abi Jamrah. Ibn Abi Jamrah was a great scholar who wrote a commentary of an abridged version of Sahih al-Bukhari. It's one of the best ever commentaries on the work of Imam al-Bukhari radiyallahu anhu. And Imam ibn Hajar al-Asqalani radiyallahu anhu, when he refers to him in his Fath al-Bi'abari, he says, قَالَ الْعَارِفُ بِاللَّهِ. He refers to him as the one who knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And upon completion of this commentary, he writes at the end of it 70 dreams that he had of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, each of them affirming his explanation of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn Abi Jamrah radiyallahu anhu, he said, al-hikmatu fi shaqqi sadrihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ma'a al-qudrati ala an yabtaliya qalbahu imanan wa hikmatan min ghayri shaqqin. He says, the wisdom behind his blessed chest being opened up, whilst Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was all-powerful in filling his heart with faith, iman, and wisdom without opening it, was az-ziyadat fi quwwati al-yaqeen. The wisdom behind this was an increasement in the strength of certitude. يقين لأنه أعطي برؤيته شق صدره وعدم تأثره بذلك ما أمن معه من جميع المخاوف العادية. Where was the strength of certitude? For whom was that strength of certitude? For the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So when he saw his chest being opened up, his heart being taken out, this gave him an extra strength of certitude in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the all-powerful and the controller of the universe, that his blessed heart was away from his body, but he was still alive sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for him to go through such a severe and intense operation, but then not to be affected by it, i.e. harmed by it, this created in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a strength of certitude by which he was not fearful and scared of any happenings that ever occurred. Nothing ever frightened him. Why? Because there can't be anything more frightening than seeing your heart being taken out and your chest being ripped open. Not once, not twice, not thrice, but four times. There can't be anything more frightening than that. There can't be anything more striking than that. There can't be anything more closer for the understanding and realization of one's intellect and mind than that. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Dhariyat, when he spoke about rizq being in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ. Allah said, it's true, just as it is, just as your speech is true to you. The way we speak, and we know that we're speaking, and we know that this is occurring in reality, Allah said, this is how true your sustenance and your provision is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? So when things are close to us, in example, they are more striking. So he said, الزِّيَادَةُ فِي قُوَّةِ الْيَقِينِ. It was an increasement in the strength of his certitude. Why? Because he was shown the opening up of his chest, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not affected by this, which meant that he became secure from all other types of fears. فَلِذَٰلِكَ كَانَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ أَشْجَعَ النَّاسِ حَالًا وَمَقَالًا. And it was for this reason, i.e. for the reason that he saw his blessed chest been ripped open and his heart been taken out four times, that he was the most bravest of people in his state and in his statement. In his state and in his statements, he was the most bravest of people, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because there can't be a fear that is greater than seeing one's own life expire, seeing one's own life being taken. وَلِذَٰلِكَ, and for this reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him, مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ وَمَا طَغَى, that his eye, that his sight did not transgress, and nor did it go beyond. It did not waver, and nor did it go beyond. I.e. when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went for Mi'raj, just before the Mi'raj, his heart was also taken out. Isn't that right? And it was washed, and then it was replaced. And then he went for the Mi'raj, and when he saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ, his sight did not waver. Why didn't it waver? Because his heart was filled with extra strengths of certitude, such that that strength didn't allow for his sight to waver and nor to transgress beyond. It was fixated upon what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted him to see. Al-fa'idatu rabi'ah, he said the fourth wisdom. في الحكمة في تكراره, he said the wisdom in it being repeated. قال الحافظ ابن حجر رحمه الله تعالى بعد أن ذكر الأولى والثالثة والرابعة ولكل من الثلاث حكمة, he said that حافظ ابن حجر أمير المؤمنين في الحديث, after he mentioned the first and the third and the fourth, he said each of these three, i.e. the first, the third and the fourth, have a wisdom. فالأولى, as for the first, فكانت في زمن الطفولية, i.e. the first occurrence was when he was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a child. لينشأ على أكمل الأحوال من العصمة من الشيطان, so that he grows up in the most perfect of states, protected from the shaitan. He said this was the wisdom in it occurring the first time. ثُمَّ عِنْدَ الْبَعْثِ, and then the third time when it occurred, the second time was the 10th, when he was 10 years of age, but the third time it occurred was at the time of revelation. زِيَادَةٌ فِي إِكْرَامِهِ, the third time it occurred was an increasement in his ennoblement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increased him in his ennoblement. لِتَلَقِّي مَا يُلْقَى إِلَيْهِ, so that he receives what is sent to him. بِقَلْبٍ قَوِيٍّ, with a strong heart. فِي أَكْمَلِ الْأَحْوَالِ مِنَ التَّطْهِيرِ, in the most perfect states of purification. In the most perfect states of purity, he receives what is sent to him of the message. إرادة العروج إلى السماء ليتأهب للمناجاة, he said then it occurred the fourth time when at the intention of being taken up to the heavens. Why? ليتأهب للمناجاة, so that he is prepared to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that he is prepared to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Imam Ibn Hajar, he explained the wisdom behind it occurring the first time, the third time and the fourth time. What did he miss out, Shuaib? What did he miss out?
He said yeah, the first time, the second time, the third time and fourth time.
No, he only spoke about the first, the third and the fourth. Which one did he miss out?
The third.
The first, the third and the fourth he spoke
the
about. Second. Are you sure? Okay.
The 10-year-old.
Yeah, there you go. Slightly over. قال الحافظ الشامي, Imam الشامي رضي الله عنه, in his seerah, سبل الهدى والرشاد في سيرة خير العباد صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, قلت, I say, وسئلت عن وسئلت عن حكمة المرة الثانية. He said, I was asked about the wisdom behind the second time. مع ذكره إياها في كتاب التوحيد جازما بها. ويحتمل أن يقال لما كان التمييز في ثامن سن التكليف شق صدره صلى الله عليه وسلم وقدس حتى لا يلتبس بشيء مما يعاب على الرجال والله أعلم. So Hafiz al-Shami, he said, as for the second time, I was asked about the wisdom of the second time and said that since 8 is the age of reason and near the age of moral responsibility. So 7 or 8, this is the age of known as Sinn al-Tamiz, an age in which a child can differentiate between things. Knows what's his and what's not his. Knows what to buy and what not to buy. So if you send a child at the age of 7 or 8 to the shop to buy you something, they'll know what to buy if you mention the items to them. Before that age, they might not know. And it's also an age which is close to the age of maturity. His heart, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was taken out and sanctified so that it would not be marred by any of the flaws of men, and Allah knows best. So at the age of Tamiz, a child at the age of 7 or 8 can not only recognize a shopping list, but can also recognize the opposite gender, can recognize the differences between the genders, right? And so to protect the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the thoughts which occur to people at the age of maturity, this is why his blessed heart was taken out at this time. وقال الحافظ ابن حجر رحمه الله تعالى ويحتمل أن تكون الحكمة في هذا الغسل لتقع المبالغة في الإسباغ بحصول المرة الثالثة كما في شرعه صلى الله عليه وسلم. Hafiz ibn Hajar also said, the wisdom behind this repeated washing may have been to attain onto the thorough cleansing which occurs with the third washing, as was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's custom when performing ablutions. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in wudu would perform wudu thrice. كان يغسل مرة مرة اثنان اثنان ثلاثة ثلاثة. He would, when he would wash parts of his body, he would wash them 3 times. So the Shaykh is saying maybe a possible wisdom for it being done 3 times was that to match it with that which he performed of his wudu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam ibn Abi Jamra rahimahullahu ta'ala, he said, وَإِنَّمَا غُسِلَ قَلْبُهُ وَقَدْ كَانَ مُقَدَّسًا وَقَابِلًا لِمَا يُلْقَى فِيهِ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ وَقُدْ غُسِلَ أَوَّلًا وَهُ صَغِيرُ السِّنِّ وَأُخْرِجَتْ مِنْهُ الْعَلَقَ إِعْظَامًا وَتَأَهُّبًا لِمَا يَلْقَى هُنَاكَ, يعني في المعراج. وقد جرت الحكمة بذلك في غير ما موضع مثل الوضوء للصلاة لمن كان متوضئاً. Imam Ibn Abi Jamra, he said, even though that the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sanctified and it was pure and it was capable of receiving what was sent to it of goodness, it was still washed when he was a young child and the portion of the shaitan was taken out to magnify him sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to prepare him for what was going to be sent to his heart on the night of Mi'raj. On the night of Mi'raj. And then he gives a beautiful comparison. He said, something like this also exists. is that if someone is also if someone is in a state of wudu and they perform another wudu on top of that, they will have reward for the second wudu even though they didn't need it. It will be an increasement of purity, increasement in purification by performing the wudu upon a wudu. Is that clear? So he says this is the example of the Prophet ﷺ. His heart is pure, it's been washed for an increasement. Not because it wasn't pure in the first instant. لِأَنَّ الْوُضُوَ فِي حَقِّهِ إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِعْظَامٌ وَتَأَهُّبٌ لِلْوُقُوفِ بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَمُنَاجَاتِهِ. So the one who is in a state of wudu but then wants to pray and then stands up and performs wudu again, this is not because he was impure, but rather this is so that he can prepare himself to stand before the Divine سبحانه وتعالى. ولذلك تسن الزيادة على الواحدة والثنتين إذا أسبغ بالأولى لأن الأجزاء قد حصل وبقي ما بعد الإسباغ إلى الثلاث إعظاما وكذلك غسل الباطن هنا بالنسبة له صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said this is one comparison, is that if someone is in a state of wudu, they have a wudu from Fajr all the way to Zuhr. But when Zuhr time comes, even though they have their wudu, they stand and perform another wudu, not to purify themselves, but rather to prepare themselves for the standing. He says this is one example. Another example is, when we actually perform wudu and wash our face the first time, a complete washing, why do we have to do it a second time and a third time? The fard has been accomplished by the first time. And if someone moves over to the arms, then that's fine. But why wash it a second time and a third time? This is to have an increasement in purity, to have an increasement in excellence in wudu. Performing the wudu with isbagh, with excellence. And the Shaykh said, and this is the example and the comparison of the inner washing of His Blessed Heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which occurred so many times. Not because it wasn't pure, wal-iyazu billah, it was pure. But to increase it in its purity, it was washed. Is that clear? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. And those who venerate and respect and honor the signs of Allah, then surely that is from the piety of the hearts. فَكَانَ الْغَسْلُ لَهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ مِنْ هَذِي الْقَبِيلِ. So his washing was from this meaning. وَإِشَارَةٍ لِأُمَّتِهِ بِالْفِعْلِ بِالتَّعَظِيمِ شَعَائِرِ كَمَا نَصَّ لَهُمْ عَلَيْهِ القول. And an indication for his ummah that they venerate and respect and honor the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these were four wisdoms and benefits as to why His Blessed Heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken out and washed. The first was the first wisdom was that he was aligned with the sacrifice of Ismail alayhi salam, but his was more intense and more greater, in that the sacrifice of Ismail alayhi salam was symbolic and that of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was real. Number two, that his heart was taken out and a portion of the shaitan was taken out so that mankind can know the perfection of his heart, that which is hidden, his inner, as they know the perfection of his outer sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Imam Ibn Abi Jamra said the third wisdom was so that by seeing such an intense operation occur and by seeing his chest being ripped open and his heart being taken out, this would place him in security from all other fears and all other terrors, and his heart would become the most bravest and the strongest of hearts, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the fourth, wisdom was concerning the repetition of the occurrences of the washing of his blessed heart. So it occurred when he was a young child to protect him from the shaitan. It occurred when he was around the age of 8, 9 or 10 to protect him at the time of tamyiz, differentiation, and at the time which is close to the time of maturity from the shaitan. The third time at the time of revelation to strengthen his heart to receive, and the fourth time to strengthen his heart to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the night of Mi'raj. And then comparisons of why his heart was washed a number of times with the comparisons of one who makes wudu and then repeats another wudu on top of that. The second wudu is not because the person is in a state of impurity, but rather for an increasement of reward. Increasement of reward. And likewise, the washing of the limbs of the body whilst performing wudu once suffices and is enough, but to do it twice and thrice is an increasement in the excellence of wudu. And so hence, likewise, the inner washing of his blessed heart, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, once, twice, thrice, and four times, was an increasement in the strength of certitude for his blessed heart, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not that it was impure in between or before any of these washings. And we'll continue, inshallah, with the remainder of the wisdoms in the next lesson. الحمد لله رب العالمين.